And Kenyan consumers could be eating contaminated meat from the country's major supermarkets. This is according to a study by World Animal Protection, which is challenging stakeholders to improve animal welfare and enable responsible use of antibiotics to reverse the trend. Dennis Otieno has more.
The study by the Animal Rights Lobby collected samples from different supermarkets in Nairobi, Nakuru, Uasin Gishu, Kisumu, Laikipia and Nyeri counties to determine presence of drug-resistant bacteria. Out of the 187 pork samples, 98.4% had bacterial growth. In 206 chicken samples, 96.6% exhibited bacterial growth.
Salmonella and Shigella are organisms that can cause disease in humans coming from animals, what we call zoonotic diseases. And essentially important, of critical importance, is that the disease they cause is it affects old and young people and sometimes can lead to a stomach upset and can even be lead to death at certain levels.
The report showing there is a direct correlation between how animals are treated and the quality of the end product. Dr. Ayamo noting that misuse of antibiotics in the food chain is impacting on public health.
If we do not cater for animals, the net effect is that we end up with poor quality product which either have antibiotic residues or have superbugs which then cause problems in human populations.
Interesting to note, the highest contamination was found in own brands managed by the supermarkets. It is against this backdrop that the organization is urging industry players to improve animal welfare practices and ensure antibiotics are not abused.
So we are saying that supermarkets should start looking at critically the policies around how they buy, who supplies, because they need to audit and ensure that the producer is doing the right thing at the production level to avoid ending up with contaminated products at the supermarket level.
Dennis Otieno, Citizen TV.